Hello and welcome to this video tutorial brought to you by tastytutes.com. In this tutorial, I will be demonstrating how to set up a work document in Adobe InDesign. In the previous video, I showcased my Scamp drawing, which shows my design idea. So I will be referencing this Scamp in order to set up the right document. So let's make a start. And I'm going to open up Adobe InDesign. Now, upon loading InDesign, by default, you will have this menu box appear. This will give you the option to open a previous document or create a new document. I want to create a new document from scratch, so I am going to go ahead and click the New Document button. Or I could come to the top menu and click File, New Document. Once clicked, I will be presented with a new document criteria menu. And it's here I need to configure my properties in order to create the right document. So let's take a quick look at my Scamp. As you can see, I need to create an A5 roll fold document that opens up to a 3-page spread. To create this, I will need to compose the back and front compositions. So this will require a 6-page setup in InDesign. So let's come back into InDesign and let's work from the top down. So I can ignore document preset for now. Let's leave that as default. I can set my intent to print. I'm going to change my page number to 6. Now I'm going to need to turn off facing pages. This needs to be off, but I'm going to leave it checked on for now as an example so we can learn later why this needs to be turned off. So keep this in mind. Next, I will start on page 1. I need to change the page size to A5. Make sure the page orientation is set to portrait. Now for columns, I'm going to set this to 2, and I'm going to set the gutter to 3 millimeters. I'm going to set margins for top, inside, and outside to 10 millimeters. And I'm going to set the bleed to 5 millimeters for everything. Don't worry about the slug for now. And with that setup, I will come to the top right and click OK. In a few moments, InDesign will create my new document. Now, by default, InDesign will start the document in normal mode. This is where I can see my document outline, all marks and guides, and all the white area around. This is the pasteboard area. Now, if I press W on the keyboard, I will activate preview mode. Now, preview mode is where I can get a good look at my document without all the guides and frame outlines. If I continue to press W, I can toggle between preview mode and normal mode like so. So keep that in mind. Now, I'm going to quickly recap on what all these lines represent. When I set up the document, remember I entered the margins, bleeds, and number of columns and gutter space. Well, here you can see them all placed for us here in normal mode. The guides are all here to help us create a precise and organized layout. The black line is the main outline of my page and also represents page folds. If I look closely, I can see I have some lines on the inside and on the outside of this line. Just outside is a red line, and this represents my bleed. Now, what is this? Well, when I export my final PDF, the printer is going to cut along the outside line, the black line. If I intend to use images or artwork that come off the edge of the document, then I will need to make sure it reaches as far as the defined bleed, so I can allow for a margin of error when the printer is trimming the document. Some printers will specify different bleed criteria, but in this example, I have gone for 5 millimeters. On the inside of the main outline, I have some magenta lines. This is my margins within the document. I will use these as a guide to keep all text and other such content inside, so as to keep a nice space around my document. And finally, down the center, I have my column gutter. This clearly divides my page into 2 columns. If at any point I want to modify the margins or columns, I can simply come up to the top menu, select Layout, then select Margins and Columns. Click this and you will see the Properties window appear. If I want to change the bleed size, however, I will have to come to File, then scroll down to Document Setup. Again, another pop-up window will appear, and here you can change the page size and orientation. Okay, so I will go more into all these guides later when I start to import images and use objects. Only then will it become clear and make a bit more sense. So at this point, I want to draw your attention to the Pages panel. If you cannot see this panel, you can come to Windows and pull it up from here. So to best communicate the following, I am just going to number my pages like so. Here I have simply placed numbers in each page. Now the Pages panel works by representing my pagination visually. As you can see here, I have my pages set up like so. And you can see that this is reflected here in my composition area. I can also use this Pages panel to determine the arrangement and order of my pages. For example, if I wanted to move my pages around, let's say take page 4 and move it to page 2, I can click and hold on the page and drag it to where I want it to go. Now you can see page 4 has become page 2. But the content from page 4 has gone with that page. So the Pages panel offers you that flexibility. I am just going to undo that and put page 4 back. You can also use the Pages panel as a way of navigating through your document. Now this document only contains 6 pages, but if it contained say 100 pages, if I was currently looking at say page 1 in my composition and I wanted to skip to the last page, I can scroll down in my Pages panel and double click on the last page and my composition window will jump to that page. So that's a useful tip to remember. Now, looking at this page setup, we can see we have the first page on its own, like so. This could be the cover and the rest of the pages seem to sit next to each other. Now, this is the default setup using facing pages. This pagination may be good for a conventional booklet, magazine, or newspaper, but it's not going to work for my design. Let's take a quick look at my Scamp. And we can see I want a booklet to open up into a 3-page spread. My current layout does not match this, so I'm going to have to address this before I begin to compose my layout. Allow me to demonstrate. First, I'm going to come up to File, scroll down and select Document Setup. And this will pop up my settings, similar to the one I saw when I first set up my document. Now, you may remember when I initially set up my document, I left the Facing Pages tab checked. If you leave this checked, you will assume the pages in the way we currently have them. Now, I need to check this off. So let's tick this Facing Page box off and click OK. Now you can see the page layout has changed in the Pages panel and also in my composition area. The pages now appear to be laid out separately, almost as individuals on top of each other. Now this would be good if I wanted to, say, create a presentation. If we change the orientation to landscape, this would be a good setup for that. So let's quickly change this back to portrait. Now, I turned off facing pages because this is going to give me flexibility to alter my pagination further, which you were about to see. So the next thing I want to do is get these pages sitting next to each other so I can get 3 on the top and 3 on the bottom, just like I have planned in my Scamp drawing. If I come to my Pages panel, like earlier, I can attempt to move the pages, but right now I can't move them where I would like. And there is a reason for this. To enable me to have the flexibility to move pages around and customize my page layout, there is one more thing I must uncheck. If I come to the top right corner of the Pages panel and click the menu icon, I will see a drop-down menu. Next, I need to scroll down and I can see Allow Document Pages to Shuffle. Now, this is currently ticked. I'm about to click this and uncheck it. Right, so at first glance, nothing has changed. But now, if you click and hold on a page and move it next to the other, you will see a black line to the right. When I release, you will see the page snap to it. If I do that again, I will then have page 1, 2, and 3 next to each other, like so. If I do the same and move page 5 and 6 next to page 4, I will end up with this new composition. This is exactly what I want. So that is how I set up my document in Adobe InDesign. Now, my design is quite specific, and the steps I have just demonstrated were necessary for my particular design. Other layouts may require other setups. In this tutorial, I had to change a few properties in order to achieve my pagination. So let's do a quick recap. To get my pagination, I had to turn off facing pages. This allowed me to change from a conventional layout to a more flexible layout, separating all pages as individuals. And finally, allowing document pages to shuffle. This allowed me the flexibility to move my individual pages around into a composition to match my design. So now the pages are organized, it's time for the next step. Now before we make a start and bring in all my artwork and text to create the layout, it's important that we are familiar with the InDesign interface. This will make you feel more comfortable in the program and make it easier to implement your design. So, in the next video, I'm going to do a brief overview of the InDesign interface and also demonstrate an effective and useful workspace setup. Remember, if you wish to skip this video, you can. Links are in the description and the downloadable PDF. See you in the next video.